All right. So I'm going to be showing you the basics of how to make a .df mod for your texture files, your texture replacements. I'm assuming that you already know how to use and set up Unity, and I'm also assuming you know the naming conventions for the files you're trying to replace. Like, you've already done this. All you want, basically, is to just turn your texture files into a compressed .df mod file, so you could actually use it like a mod. You don't have to put loose files into the textures folder or anything like that. First of all, be in the Unity editor. Second of all, have your texture files. So I'm going to show you in the file explorer where you want your textures to be, how to make and build the mod, basically where to put your textures for that purpose and everything like that. Basically, first of all, I'll show you what place in the Unity editor version you will put your files to basically show them in the loose form. I guess it's probably better if I just do it in the scene like this. So where your textures would be when you want to have loose files, the streaming assets folder under textures. You'd put your desired textures in that folder, and when you run Unity, or when you run the game, whatever, it would replace the textures with those files. That is the most rudimentary way to do it. Through this way, I'm going to show you how to do it through, or making a .df mod instead. First step that I would do is go to the folder game over here, and then go under mods. This is a completely separate thing from the normal live version where the streaming assets are. This is specifically for the Unity editor, basically. And what I do here, at least, is this is where I put my in-progress working on mods, basically. First, what I would do, just to make it more organized, I'll say show and explore, just because I like to use the explorer better here. But inside this mods folder, I'm going to make a folder. Name it anything. I try to name it whatever the mod name will be. So in this case, we'll say texture replacements test. You can name it anything you want. And then inside of this is, well, first I'll show you how to basically use this to start your .df mod file. And this is where it's going to be housed, essentially. Go up to the toolbar. You should have this up here if you have the Unity editor running properly in a DFU project, basically. Daggerfall Unity project. So go to Daggerfall Tools. Go to Mod Builder. And it should probably be empty. So what you'll do is create, go to the top left, create new mod. This is going to be the name of the .json file, essentially. So I would name it the same thing as your mod. Is it at the, like, what it's going to be in the end? So in this case, just going to name it texture, the same thing, texture replacements.test, and then save inside of the folder you just made. There we go. Save. And now you will see in your file explorer, the texture replacements folder now has these two files, the .json and the .meta. The .meta files are always created for anything in it that is imported into a Unity project, basically. Most of the time, it's not stuff that you really care about. Sometimes, like I'll show you later, it is important. But in this case, the one that you care about most is this .json file. But now that you have the actual file open, you can do the various things of creating a proper, I guess you could say, mod profile, whatever you want to say. So the mod title, same thing. Texture, you know, you can make it anything, but this is just how I do it. Texture replacements test version, I usually go by that, but you can do it however you want. Mod creator, we'll just say Magicano in this case. Contact info, you know, optional, whatever. This is important, the actual Daggerfall Unity version that you're building for. In this case, 0.14 just released, basically earlier this morning, so I'm building it in this fresh environment. For you, do whatever version environment that you're building in, most likely. For this, and like I said, in this case, it's for 0.14. For you, it might be 0.13.5, whatever. Make it anything, but it is important to have that correct. Mod description, make it whatever. Replaces textures. Now, all this other stuff is important. This number matters too. This is the mod GUID, which is basically the unique identifier for your mod that every mod will have. If it matches with another, then you will have conflicts and problems. So just always make sure it generates something, whatever. I mean, it usually it'll automatically generate one, but yeah. If you do copy and pasting for other stuff, make sure you always change the GUID to something else if you make another mod. Dependencies editor, that's not necessary here. Add selected assets. This is important. Add selected assets, remove selected assets, clear all assets. This dropdown, you'll see what assets you have in this mod, basically. What are being brought into this mod when it is built. And any files that you use, any assets that you use, you are required, otherwise it won't work, when you actually build it, you are required to put whatever assets in this, or are at least tell it what assets are supposed to be in there. We're not going to do that yet, because first we'll actually put the textures in there, and then we'll import them. All this other stuff, not important in some ways. Collect dependencies, that's, in this case, it most likely isn't important. We're not going to be using any scripts or code, so not important in this case. Compression type, I don't change it. I always leave it to LZ4. Never had any problems with that. In this case, I don't have the OSX or the Linux builds for my editor, so I can't build for the OSX or the Linux, but I do have it for Windows, which is the one that I primarily build for, so I always have that checked. And this is important too, so you don't lose where it is set your build path, which in this case, it defaults to the assets folder, which is fine. So we're just going to leave it here, or just going to say, yeah, leave it there where it was by default. Precompile, that's for something later. And if you want to save these settings, you don't have to, if you want to just save these settings or anything that you change, just do save mod settings the file. Just click that anytime you want to save whatever you just did. So now we're going to close this. And now our .json file has been updated with this. But now we're going to get down to the meat and potatoes, which is or putting the textures in this mod. So the way we're going to do that is that we now have our folder here, and we can open it. But I like to use the Explorer, so we'll just do this. Back to mods, we're in that folder. So in this folder, we will create another folder and call it textures. And this will basically like kind of be replicating or telling it when it's built to use that folder, almost as if you're using loose files, but it's different, sort of. But make sure that that file is that. Name that, at least. It might be able to work in other ways, but I haven't really tried, so I'm not concerned about it. But just make a folder called textures within your mod folder here. You could probably put subfolders for different kind of things. I'm not going to show that in this case. I'm just going to show a very simple texture replacement here. We are going to be replacing the tower shield texture for every race, every gender of each race. You'll see we got 8 textures here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All with their different archive numbers as well as their different index numbers for the texture. In this case, like I said, it's the tower shield and of the type steel. And we got all the different races for them, so we just have it in this folder now. Now, we have to let Unity refresh and then create metadata for these images. And it'll take, usually a second, not even. And you will see that after you refresh, basically just click in the window. And you'll see now it has all these metadata after it imported those images. That metadata is important because, unlike with normal loose texture replacements, it does matter. You have to do a little bit of preparation, kind of, beforehand. Because with the loose textures, it kind of automatically does the compression stuff and everything. with textures coming from a modded file or a .dfmod file, the imported textures need to have the metadata properly changed, because that's what Unity gives it, basically, for its settings. And if you don't do this, you're going to, basically the result is going to be you're going to have a very blurry image, because it's doing some kind of auto-aliasing or whatever, some kind of filtering or compression process that you don't want it to do, in this case, for sprites. You might want to do it for different kind of textures, but in this case, for sprites, you don't want it. We'll do the drop-down for our textures file. And when you click on this in the Unity editor, you will see it has, to the right of here, in the inspector window, you know, it might be on a different screen for you or something like that, but for me, I have it on the right here. And it has all these different settings. So what we're first going to do is select all the textures that we want. We could just, you know, select one from the list at the top and then hold shift and click down, and then you'll have all eight of them, all of your textures selected at once. Up here, you will see in the inspector, texture type, you want to change this from default to sprite, 2D and UI, sprite. When you change it to that, it'll give some more options. And what you want to change here afterward is, I mean, you could change anything else here if you want to, if you know what you're doing. But I don't know what I'm doing when it comes to texture stuff. But this is what I do to not have a blurry, messed up image when I actually have a modded stuff in. Most of this stuff doesn't matter, generally. I like to uncheck generate physics. I don't know if it does anything. It probably doesn't, but I just do. But the other big important one, this one can have, it is important. I would say always check read/write enable, because otherwise I've seen problems where people can't, the textures don't show up, basically, or you can't, they don't show up properly, or they have issues. So I would say make sure to always have read/write enable checked. Wrap mode, I don't think matters. And this is the other important one, is filter mode. Bilinear, put it to point, no filter. This is, I believe, like, maybe the other ones, like, there's probably good reasons, maybe, but this is what I always put it to, and I've not had issues for that, in that regard. And then scroll, when you've done that, so you have now texture type is sprite, read/write enable is checked, and filter mode is whatever you want it to be. I would suggest point, no filter for sprites. But then use and scroll down, make sure that you hit apply, and it'll apply the changes to all the textures you had selected. So now all of them will have their associated metadata changed to what settings you have done. So when you have, basically when you see that, when you have the little drop-down form, that probably means that you did it right that time. So now that we have that, we have the textures there. What we want to do now is go back to the mod builder window. Make sure that your mod is open. In this case, it opened right back to it because I just had it open. Now, you will... Alright, I'm going to drag this off the window for a second. But make sure that you have your textures selected in the editor. And then, when you have them selected, do click Add Selected Assets. And all of your assets will be added, including their metadata and everything. It's just attached to it, basically. So then you have your assets in the mod, imported into the mod, which is the important part. So just for sake of it, save. Now that you have the texture assets properly added, or whatever you want to say, imported into the mod, that was basically the biggest step. It's just getting those assets in there into this mod builder window. So now, essentially all you have to do, you could test it in debug mode if you wanted to by launching the game, but I'm not going to show that. I'm just going to show you how to do this, how to build the .dfmod file so you can use it in the live game. So you're still in the mod builder window. So I would suggest hitting pre-compile. Check that. For texture replacements like this, you're probably not going to need it, but for every other mod, we've had some of us have had issues with mods not using this option, so I'd suggest just doing it. I don't think it really hurts anything to do it, but I think it could hurt more if you don't in some cases. But anyway, with that checked, you have all your name and everything, all the stuff that you wanted, as you want it. You have your textures imported properly. Now, you just hit build mod. And you tell it to build in the spot. You tell it to build wherever, but in this case, I'm going to tell it to build where it was by default, which is in the assets folder of the Unity editor instance. So I'll hit save with whatever the .dfmod name you wanted. I would just keep it the same as the mod name personally. And now you just wait for it to build. Sometimes it takes a little bit, other times it doesn't take very long. Usually, maybe give it 1-2 minutes most of the time and you should be good. And yeah, like I said, just give it like maybe even 2-3 minutes sometimes, 2-5 minutes. I mean, it usually doesn't take that long, but depends, I suppose. But you'll see this, just be patient. I wouldn't hit cancel because then you're probably not going to mess up much, but I wouldn't hit cancel just unless you really want to. And it won't tell you that it's completed when it is done. This window will just close, which it probably will in a second here. And it just did. And what basically, if you come back, it'll probably give you a few warnings in the error log, whatever you want to call it, the debug log. Now, unless there was any errors that came up in your console, your mod has been built, compressed into a .dfmod. So, close out, X out of the editor now. And now, we will find the actual dfmod file by going to, just close out some of this for clarity, go to standalone Windows, which just was created, because standalone Windows is basically just where it got built, essentially. It made a new folder for that. So I'll open it up in the Explorer, because I like the Explorer better. And what you'll see in here is these things, standalone Windows, completely ignore them. The only one you care about of these 8 that will show up is this one, the your mod name .dfmod. That's it. Every other one with any other extension is basically useless or garbage, whatever. So this is the one that you care about. In this case, some people might copy it, others might do other things with it. I'm going to cut it, and I'm going to bring it back to the desktop. You don't have to do this, but I like to do it. I just delete the other useless files that were there, just for clarity, I guess. I'll close out of that Explorer. If you don't care about testing or whatever, you could close out of Unity if you wanted to. In this case, I'm going to just show it, because you could do the same thing with launching the game, testing it in Unity with a live copy of your .dfmod, and I guess I'll show you how to do that. Basically, just go to standalone, or your streaming assets folder, and throw it in the mods folder, which is, you know, how you normally mod the game. Just throw it in this mods folder, where streaming assets are, and then when you actually hit play, up there, I'm not going to hit it, when you hit play, then your mod will actually be the live version in that, if you want to test it in the Unity editor instead. In my case, I'm going to show how to just do it in a live build. I mean, you probably know what's going to happen now. But I'm going to basically find the live build of this, go to the streaming assets, as you'd expect, go into the mods folder, take our now new .dfmod file, put it in there, and then we will launch the game. And when we actually get into the game, we will see that the .dfmod file should be in there, in the mods section. As you see, texture replacements test. We have all of our info and everything. You could enable it, disable it. By default, it's enabled. See the mod description. And yeah, change it, whatever. But right now it's on. So I'm going to test it by just hitting play. Yeah, I'll just do it that way. So I'll just load a save that I... just whatever random save. Doesn't matter in this case. This was a fresh save for other testing, but I will just do the console command add all equip... add all equip armor, and then when I check in my inventory, I should check the tower shields that are steel should be this, and they are. Now, you can see your texture replacement. There's no loose file here. This is all through a .dfmod file. So this is how you get your texture replacements into a .dfmod file like this. So, there's Mr. Krabs. Are you feeling it, Mr. Krabs? And yeah. And you can upload this as you please, as a normal mod file. And yeah, I can't think of anything else that I need to say. This is probably way too long, but hopefully I can cut it down. Yeah. Thanks for watching, and I hope that helped.